Hello dear students, in today's class we will learn about the working of dual slope integrating type digital voltmeters. In the last class we discussed about the working of ramp type digital voltmeter. Here in this dual slope integrating type DVL we use the same ramp technique to find the equivalent digital voltage for the input supply. Now this dual slope technique actually helps to reduce the noise in the input signal. For example, as we will see later, in this mechanism we have both positive slope region and the negative slope region, which will help us to reduce the noise in the signal. Now coming to the working of the dual slope DVL, this is the block diagram corresponding to this device, this instrument. The voltage to be measured is fed here as EI, and this is being fed into an integrator here. Now as we know, an op amp which is working like an integrator . We have resistance and capacitors that are connected in this manner. And as we know, an integrator will integrate the input voltage. So if we are feeding a constant EI as the input voltage to an integrator, the output of the integrator will be a linearly increasing voltage. The integrator will be integrating that. So as the output of the integrator, EO, we will have a linearly increasing voltage whose slope is actually proportional to the input voltage EI. And this output voltage EO is fed into a comparator here. One of the inputs of the comparator is EO coming from the integrator here, and the other input is ground voltage or zero voltage. So as we know, a comparator will be comparing the two input voltages and will be giving an output depending on the difference between them. So since this output EO is greater than the zero voltage, the comparator output will be 1 as soon as we start to feed in the EI voltage. Before that, we will have zero voltage here. But the moment we start to feed in this EI voltage, there will be an EO. And this EO, when compared to zero, since it is greater than 1, since EO is greater than the zero voltage, we will have 1 here. And what does this output of the comparator do? It is actually controlling a gate here. This acts like the control of a gate. And the other input of the gate is the pulses coming from our oscillator. The oscillator is always producing pulse, but the gate, the AND gate that we have here, is closed at the moment. But when the comparator gives 1 as output, this gate will be activated and it will be open, because we know 1 into A is A. The moment we have 1 as the input, one of the input of the gate, this pulse will be passing through the gate. This pulse is being fed into a counter, and we know a counter will count the number of pulses. So the moment the gate opens, the pulse will start to flow through the gate, and the counter will start to count from 0000 to higher numbers. So this process will continue. The counter will count until the gate is open. And we know the gate will be open always, since EO is always greater than zero voltage. So as long as there is an input voltage supply, as long as the integrator is integrating and the comparator is giving a 1 output, the oscillator output will be passing through the gate and the counter will be counting. So this mechanism will continue until the counter counts up to 9999, the maximum count. So there is no interruption until then, because everything will be working as it is until that value, because the input voltage is being fed into the system. The integrator will be integrating always. Comparator will be comparing and giving 1 as the output. The gate will be open and the counter will continuously count from the zero value up to the maximum value. And the moment the counter reaches the maximum value, it will activate a flip-flop here. And the flip-flop is connected to a switch drive, which shifts the switch from the input voltage to another fixed voltage here. The counter counts from zero to maximum value, and when the counter reaches maximum value, the switch is switched on or flipped. And what does the switch do? This switch shifts the input of the integrator from the EI voltage to ER voltage. Now, what are these voltages, EI and ER? EI is the voltage that we feed into the system. EI is the input voltage that we want to measure. And ER is a fixed voltage, or minus ER is a fixed voltage that we have inside the system. That is a constant voltage. EI is the input varying voltage depending on the input we want to measure, and ER is a fixed voltage within the system itself. And since it is a negative voltage, since we are feeding it to the integrator, the output then will be a voltage, linearly varying voltage, whose slope is minus ER. That means the voltage will continuously decrease from there the moment we give in the negative voltage. So in the earlier case, we had already integrated the input voltage to a particular value, say suppose this is EO. From there, the integrator now starts to reduce its output voltage, and the voltage will linearly decrease proportional to minus ER. The slope will be proportional to minus ER. So initially the slope is proportional to EI, so we have increasing output voltage from the integrator, and the moment we shift the input, it will start to integrate again, but the integration, the slope is minus ER, so the voltage starts to decrease at the output side. But even then, the comparator will show 1 as the output, because that voltage is greater than 0, right? This is the 0 line, the input voltage and the output, sorry, the output voltage is always greater than 0. And when would this value change from 1 to 0? When this output touches the 0 voltage, after a long time of integration, this voltage will continuously drop and reach 0. And when that voltage reaches 0 value, the comparator output will be switched back to 0, because this is 0 voltage. And when this voltage drops down to 0, the comparator can no more give you 1 as the output, because this is not greater than, the output voltage here is not greater than the ground voltage. So the comparator is acting like a 0 detector. It is telling you whether this input is greater than 0 or not. And when this comparator output changes from 1 to 0, the gate will be closed. After that, no pulse can pass through the system. So before that, there is a time period T2 during which the gate is open, during which the integrator is giving out negative slope output, and the detector is, zero detector is feeding 1, and during that time the counter will count the number of pulses that has passed through the gate. So let me explain once again. Initially, when the input voltage was EI, this EI was fed into the comparator. Comparator gave you positive slope output, and the zero detector gave you 1 as the output. The gate remained open, and the counter started counting from 0 up to 9999. And when the counter reached the maximum value, the flip-flop got activated. The switch flipped the switch from EI to minus ER. And during minus ER input, again the integrator is integrating, E output is there, only that the slope of this output voltage is negative, it is going down to 0. And during that time as well, the 0 detector will give you 1 as the output, and the gate is open, and the counter is cleared. After it is reaching 9999, it will again start to count. And when this output E out reaches 0 value, this gate will be closed, and the counter will display some value depending on how many number of pulses pass through the gate. So we can definitely say that there are two time periods. There is T1 and T2. T1 is the time period during which EI is fed through the integrator and the comparator. During this time, the counter counts up to 9999. After that, the counter will be cleared. The flip-flop will be switched. The switch will flip the input voltage. And after that, we start counting again from 0 onwards. And from here up to the end point, the counter will again count. But it will not be able to count up to 9999. It will only be able to count up to a specific value. And when the EO drops to 0, this value drops to 0, the 0 detector will give you 0 as the output, and the gate will close, and the counter will stop counting there. So these are the two time periods, T1. During T1, we have EI being fed into the system, and the counter will be counting until 9999. And during T2, minus ER is fed into the system, and the counter will count up to a specific value. We do not know that value. The counter will count until the EO drops down to 0. So this is the basic working mechanism within a dual slope DVM. And if we analyze the system, we can see that the second time period T2 is actually a function of the input voltage EI. Here in the system, T1 is fixed. T1 is the time taken by the counter to count from 0 up to 9999, the maximum value. It will be a constant for whatever inputs. But T2 will depend on the input voltage value EI. Now let us try to formulate an equation and try to understand that more. We will come back to this concept after that derivation. So as you can see, we know the output voltage EO will be equal to minus 1 by RC integral 0 to T1 EI into DT. So this is the output of the comparator, the integrator. The EO value, the maximum EO value will be minus 1 by RC integral 0 to T1 EI DT, because we are integrating with EI as the input voltage from 0 up to T1. Now, this is equal to minus EI into T1 divided by RC. Now, again, during the negative slope, minus ER is fed into the system, and we are integrating with minus ER as the input. So let me write EO is equal to minus 1 by RC integral 0 to T2 minus ER DT. This should be the equation. Now, since the integrator started from EO value and it is going down, we didn't start from the 0 value, right? And we are not going down up to minus E0. Minus EO, we should neglect this negative sign, since we already started from EO value and going down as we progress. When we integrate from 0 to T2, we are going from EO up to 0, not from 0 up to minus EO, and that is why we are neglecting the negative sign here. So this will be equal to minus ER into T2 divided by RC. Now we know this EO and EO are equal. From up to here, we integrated up to EO, and from EO, we integrated up to 0. This EO value, the maximum that is reached, is same, one and same. So I can equate these equations 1 and 2. Therefore, I can write EI into minus EI into T1 divided by RC is equal to minus ER T2 divided by RC. So cancelling certain terms, we get EI is equal to ER into T2 divided by T1. Now what is T2? T2 is the time taken for this negative slope region, and T1 is the time taken for the positive slope region. T1 is always a constant, because T1 is in fact the time taken by the counter to count from 0 up to maximum, from 0000 to 9999. That is when the counter closes. So this T1 is always a constant. Now the T2 will vary depending on the EI value. So of this, ER is a constant, ER is the system value, T1 is a constant, T2 is the variable. So T2 will determine what is the input voltage EI. Now we have T2 will be equal to N2 times T. N2 is the count that is shown in the counter and T is the time taken for each count. Similarly, T1 is equal to N1 into T. So let me write N1 is the counter count and T is the time for each count. Similarly, N2 is the counter shown count and T is the time for each count. So I can rewrite this as ER into N2 T divided by N1 T, which is equal to ER into N2 by N1. ER is a constant and N1 is a constant. N1 is in fact the maximum count and N2 is the variable. So depending on the count that is shown on the counter during the second time, we can calculate the input voltage EI. So since ER and N1 are constant, let me call ER divided by N1 as K. So I can write EI is equal to K into N2. So N2 is the count that is shown in the counter during the second time. So N1 is this count shown during the first time, which is the maximum value of the counter. And N2 is the count that is shown on the counter during the second time. Now this is the basic concept. We have the equation EI equal to K into N2. Depending on the count indicated in the counter during the second time, we can find the input voltage value EI. As an add-on, let me just make it clear for you what is actually happening inside the DVM. So suppose we are feeding in a small voltage EI into the system. Since the voltage is very small, the integrator will be integrating with a very small slope, maybe like this. And the integrator will continue to integrate as long as we are feeding EI into the system. And the comparator will give you 1, the gate will be open, the counter will be counting up to maximum. And during that time, up to T1, up to the time when the counter is counting from 0 up to maximum, the integrator will keep on integrating. And it will reach a value EU. After the counter reaches the maximum count, the switch will be flipped and minus ER will start to act. That is a constant value. And that constant negative voltage will decrease the output of the integrator and it will be switched back to 0. Now if we are supplying a high input voltage EI into the system, the integrator will be integrating with a higher slope since the input voltage is very high, and the integrator will keep on integrating until the counter is counting from 0 up to maximum. So it will reach a higher voltage EO here. And after reaching that moment, when the counter reaches the maximum count, the switch will be flipped and the output of the comparator will be again 1. And this integrator will decrease its voltage from EO to a 0 with a constant slope. Minus ER is the slope here. So in this case and in this case, the slope is same. The rate of change of voltage from maximum to minimum will be same. So which one will take higher time to reach 0? This voltage will reach a higher time to reach the 0 value. So this gate will be open for a longer time in the case of higher input voltage. If the input voltage is very small, the EO value that is reached will be lower and the integrator, output of the integrator will fall down very fastly when we provide this minus ER voltage. So this T2 is small in the case of small input voltage and T2 is large in the case of high input voltage. So this is why The system is also called voltage to time conversion. The input voltage is in fact being converted into time. If the input voltage is high, the time taken for the integrator to fall down back to zero will be higher, and the counter will hence be open for a longer time. If the input voltage is low, the time taken for the integrator to fall down to zero will be very small, and the counter will count only for a short duration of time. So this counter will actually indicate how much is the voltage that is being fed. Small count means small input voltage EI, and a large count means large input voltage EI. And we will set this apparatus in such a way that this EI voltage actually determines the count. Suppose it is 10 voltage, we set it in such a way that the counter will read 10. If it is 100 voltage, we set the counter in such a way that it will read 100. So we can do that by adjusting the time period, right? Time period of the count. And the integrating function and so on, this ER value, everything will determine the match between this input voltage and the counter. So as of now, I hope that the basic working mechanism of dual slope technique is clear for you. We have two slopes. One is EI and the other one is minus ER. Minus ER is always a constant that is coded in the system. EI is our input varying voltage. So this is how voltage is being converted into time. And that time can be measured, used to measure the voltage by using counters and other setups that we have. So I hope that this portion is clear for you. I hope that this equation is clear for you. Try to read about this apparatus and try to build up some idea about working of dual slope integrating type DVM. Thank you.